Championship Wrestling continues on ESPN. Eric, coming up, a guy who already thinks he should be referred to as the light heavyweight champion of the world.
Well, we know him as the illustrious one, Jonnie Stewart.
He's in there with a big man, Spike Jones, out of Junction City. Let's get the announcements.
With a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first in the ring at 248 pounds from Junction City, Kansas, here is Spike Jones. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponents now making his way to the ringside area. He weighed at 232 pounds. He hails from Pacific Palisades, California. Here is illustrious Jonnie Stewart.
Now hold on. I don't want you calling ESPN. I don't want you sending any letters in. Obviously, the ring announcer made a big mistake, and I mean big. Spike Jones is 283 pounds, and I bring that up only because Jonnie Stewart, 232 pounds, talking about being the light heavyweight champion of the world.
Well, he's talking a little bit too soon. He's got some business to take care of with Buck Zuma before he can make that statement.
Well, as a matter of fact, that match has already been signed. There will be a new light heavyweight champion of the world. It will either be the illustrious Jonnie Stewart or the original rock and roller, Buck Rock and Roll Zuma. And I'll tell you what, Eric, if Jonnie Stewart is in this match looking at Spike Jones, 283 pounds out of Kansas, as a warm-up, he's out of his mind.
Yeah, he's making a mistake. You know, they call, in Junction City, Kansas, they call him the man with no neck, and you can see why. Take a look at him.
Well, oh, what's this? Spoiled rotten. Yeah, okay, yeah, we know.
And he's proud of it.
Wait a minute, what's he saying? Look at this guy? How could you miss him? I always thought that Spike Jones, I mentioned this on ESPN earlier, looks to me like a phone booth with just a big old clump of hair on top. I mean, he's all the way big.
He's a powerful man. I mean, take a look at the legs on him. He's got a real low center of gravity, and he moves surprisingly well for a big man. 283 pounds. He moves like a cat in that ring when he wants to.
Maybe that's why Jonnie Stewart wanted a match with Spike Jones. Get in there with a big, strong guy who can move like a light heavyweight. Maybe Jonnie Stewart picked a good opponent. Now, maybe I would like to rethink that statement.
And maybe he made a mistake.
Spike Jones with a standing bear hug, cranking the pressure on the illustrious one. Referee trying to see if Stewart wants to give it up. There are only two ways to break this hold, and that's one of them.
There you go.
The other way is to put your hands inside the other man's grip. Right hand by Jonnie Stewart. He's got Spike Jones reeling now. Into the turnbuckle goes Jones.
You know, I would think that Jonnie Stewart wouldn't want to go toe-to-toe with a man as big as Spike Jones.
Well, you want to be impressed. Look at that. Punctuated by a flying elbow. He's going to go for the cover, Eric. One, two,
whoa. That's a kick out, Lee Marshall.
Almost a three count, indeed. A kick out with authority.
Sent Jonnie Stewart airborne.
Left hand by Jonnie. Another left. He's jabbing away now. A third left. And that sends Spike down. Double sledge by Jonnie Stewart. And he's got him draped over the ropes. Referee saying stay off the choke. A little late. DeRusha just a little late on the uptake. If he was going to get him off the choke, he should have done it as he was doing it. Don't tell me he's going to try for the suplex here.
Boy, and he's giving up 50 pounds, Lee Marshall. I don't really like Jonnie Stewart all that well, but you got to hand it to him. He just took a man that outweighs him by 50-some-odd pounds and threw him like a sack of potatoes.
Snap suplex, and down went Jones. Jones answering back with a couple of thundering right forearms, and now Stewart moving back in, and again throwing the lefts, the rights, another left, the right, and Jones answering back going, come on, boy, I got some of this for you. Couple of big right hands by Spike Jones. Into the turnbuckle. Wow.
Again, that's twice now that we've seen Stewart try to go toe-to-toe with Spike Jones, and both times it failed.
Big mistake. Big mistake. Don't posture for the fans. If you're going to move in on the man, move in on him. Now Jones going to work. Could be too late. Reversal.
Oh man, face right into that turnbuckle.
Watch this knee now, Eric.
Yeah, we've seen this before. This is a patented Jonnie Stewart move here with that knee.
You know, somebody asked me not that long ago after the match was signed between Jonnie Stewart and Buck Zumoff to pick who I thought was going to win. And it was a very unpopular statement, but I'll make it publicly. I think you're looking at Jonnie Stewart, the new light heavyweight champion of the world.
Ooh.
And I think, I know that I'm ruffling a lot of feathers, but it is because of that knee and also the man's ability as a wrestler. He can. and wrestle. It may say Spoiled Brat on the back of his tights, but make no mistake about it. You're not, you know, talking about some goof who can't wrestle, who paints his face and dances around. This man can wrestle. And he just loaded up that knee and dropped it right into the midsection of Spike Jones. And the man he's going to have to face for the title.